This is Chia-Yu. Today I'm going to present our work, real-time GeoAI for high-resolution mapping and segmentation of Arctic permafrost features. In this work, we will use ice-wedge polygon as an example. So, permafrost feature is a frozen layer at or below 0 degrees Celsius for at least 2 years. And recently, global warming is driving dramatic changes to the Arctic ecosystem, especially the permafrost. So thawing permafrost has significant local and global impact. For example, the land subside will cause damages to the buildings or roads. So the mapping of permafrost features can improve our understanding of permafrost dynamics and its linkage to the Arctic ecosystem. Previous research already leveraged the GeoAI and the big data to support automated mapping of permafrost features. So for example, on the left-hand side, this is a workflow called Maple. It adopts Mask-RCNN to segment ice-wedge polygon. And on the right-hand side, this is another work using semantic segmentation model to segment snow slumps. However, we propose that a more efficient permafrost mapping is required at the pan-Arctic scale. Take the Maple work in the previous slide as an example. The authors need to deal with 25,000 satellite images with over 180 terabytes of data. And each satellite image, it has 160 million pixels with multispectral channels. In order to process the image by the GPU due to limited memory, the authors, they need to split each satellite image into more than 40,000 image tiles. So as we can imagine, even with a powerful workstation or HPC, it can still take lots of time to process the data to do the prediction. So in this work, we demonstrate the use of a real-time deep learning model for Arctic permafrost feature mapping. The work we demonstrate is called SparseInst. It's proposed in 2022. As the table shows, it can achieve comparable accuracies with much faster inference speed. And on the right-hand side, this is the model architecture of the sparse instance. It contains three components. First is feature extractor. It extracts features from the image. And the second is encoder. It basically encodes feature map, different feature maps with different scale information into one single feature map. And the last is decoder. It basically generates class scores or masks from the input feature for each instance. So how does this model, how does sparse instant improve the speed? First, the improvement is single level prediction. Normally, to handle the scale variation of objects in the image, most methods will adopt multi-scale feature fusions and multi-level predictions. So you basically have different feature maps, and each feature map has its own scale information, and you will apply on each feature map. But for SparseInst, in order to improve the speed, SparseInst leveraged single-level prediction. It only applies prediction on one feature map, on single level feature map. But to handle the scale variation issue, it encodes different scale informations from different feature maps into one single level output feature. So this output feature will contain multi-scale representations. And the second improvement is to avoid non-maxima separation. So Most methods will generate a bunch of candidates, no matter it's a two-stage, one-stage, anchor-based, or center-based. The number of candidates can from several hundreds to several thousands. So during the training, each ground truth can match multiple candidates. So you will have multiple positive samples. And during the inference, non-maximal separation is applied to field the candidates and to select the best prediction. So non-maximal separation involves sorting and the comparison between candidates. It's basically a linear operation, so it will slow down the inference speed. To avoid non-maximal separation, sparse instance applied one-to-one matching. So this model will still predict a fixed number of predictions, but during the training, each ground truth can only match one candidate by pattern matching, and there's only one positive sample for each ground truth. So only this positive sample will get a high class score. So during inference, these class scores are used to filter the candidates. And the number of candidates is 500 in our work. So as the performance matrix shows, sparse instance can get a slightly better accuracy with much faster inference speed. And on the right-hand side, since the number of predictions is a hyperparameter for sparse instance, we did an experiment of different number of candidates versus their corresponding accuracies and the speed. So as the figure shows, the higher the number of candidates, the slower the model. But in the same time, it can achieve a higher accuracy. And in this figure, both the 500 model and the 300 model, they both have a better accuracy than Mask-RCNN. So takeaways. So in this work, we first introduced permafrost feature mapping is important for understanding the permafrost dynamics and the impacts of global warming. And second, we proposed that a more efficient model is required for large-scale feature mapping. And we demonstrate the use of a sparse instance. It can achieve much faster inference speed by single-level prediction and one-to-one matching to avoid non-maximal separation.